Imagine if you could see through your walls. What do you think you'd find? It's probably not going to be money, but what is lurking could still help you create a better quality of life. Most people think about insulation in their walls, but as an energy auditor, I see walls as pathways for air to enter or escape a house. This video is going to help homeowners with older houses understand three invisible places that are practical to check and make airtight. To help you fully understand, I visited a new construction house that had the plumbing, HVAC, and electrical installed, but not the drywall. One small lesson that you've got to sort of wrap your head around. Every house has six sides to the outside, and the trickiest to grasp is the top. I find myself telling people all the time at energy audits that despite being covered by the roof, the attic is still technically considered the outside. An easy way to think about this is when you have a lot of twists and turns in your house, think about the spaces that are conditioned versus the spaces that are unconditioned. And remember this, air is going to move in every which way throughout a house if it's not controlled. Sealing your house in the right places is going to give you more control over your indoor air temperatures by keeping conditioned air in and unconditioned air out. The good news is that most of these fixes are in the attic, making them accessible. When it comes to plumbing, I think it's safe to say that most people think copper pipes. But did you know that plumbing systems also use air? Take a look at any roof, and if you see one of these, you're going to think about your house and the plumbing in a completely different way. Look how it extends from the roof down to the different areas of the house that will need water. Look how they drill the holes in the tops of the walls. And these holes and these pipes go all throughout the house, all the way down to the basement. Guess what? Walls have dead space and air lives in that dead space. One way to think about all this is that if these holes aren't sealed, not only is the air inside of the pipe going to go up and out, but so is all of the air on the outside of the pipe as well. I'm going to show you soon how to fix this problem. Electricity can be a scary thing, but this one's really easy. I challenge you to count each of your switches and outlets in rooms below attic spaces. I promise it's a lot of small holes, and they add up to huge amounts of air leakage in a house. And that doesn't even include any mistake holes that have nothing even going through them. In a moment, I'm going to show you a clear example of how to fix this problem. HVAC passageways. Most people don't even realize that you have a small room inside of your house that you're never going to spend any time in, but it does serve a purpose for your heating and cooling system. In older houses, the area is often open at the attic floor. This can be a little tricky to understand, so think it through. When you know that the attic is the outside, it gets a little easier to realize this problem is the exact same thing as leaving a window open 365 days a year, which you probably wouldn't do. Check out how we fixed this problem for a homeowner, and it made a big difference in their lives. Watch how easy it is to air seal an electrical wire hole at the top of a wall. Sealing up plumbing stacks, easy as 1, 2, 3. If you're interested in learning more about how to make the invisible visible when it comes to creating a comfortable home and a better quality of life, subscribe to my channel at Home Air Leakage Test. And if you're in Maryland, set up your $100 energy audit right now online at HomeAirLeakageTest.com.